Hello, my sexy peeps. It's me, Brenda again, Lactic Sister. And I had talked to my bestie, Whimsy, and told her I had a rock gem collection that I've collected from different places. So, this would be a video of that. I'm not sure how interested people are in that, but that's my thing too. I collect them, and when I can, a lot of my stuff is mainly from like the desert in Arizona. Maybe a gem show or two, just stuff like that. Stuff I've collected over the years, and this is actually a quite heavy, huge slab of I don't know what. I cannot tell you the names of some of the rocks and gems and stuff because I really don't know the names to them. I haven't looked them up, but this is what I use for a small altar. It's pretty heavy. I'm not sure exactly how heavy. I've never weighed it, but I lay things on this when I'm doing things or used to. I haven't done it so much lately because life and in general, I really should get back into doing my things that brought me peace and tranquility and stuff like that. But anyhow, that's one of the things. One of the large stones. I'm not really sure. Let's get down here. What this is, what this stone is, it's smooth, but I found it and it looked to me like a heart, so I kept it for that reason, because it looks like a heart to me. I have collected two orbs. Oops. And you can't even see them down there. They're good just to fiddle with when I'm thinking. They're both about the same size. Don't know what they're made out of. But I keep that. I believe this one is glass. I don't know. I see, as you can see, chips and etching on it, but that don't always mean anything, and I'm not sure what that is made out of, but I have those. Let's see what else. Oops. I have some clear, I believe, quartz. I think that's what these are, is some kind of quartz. I'll probably have to look all these up. I believe I got these at a gem or native store. Most of them are, like I said, bought or found in Arizona. So I had those. Here's a crystal. I went to go see this one place. I could probably post pictures of this one place in, oh good Lord, Iowa or somewhere. I can't remember. A grotto? Something like that? I'd have to look it up. I'm one that if I ain't there constantly, I will not remember the name too. But this is laying loose on the ground, so I snatch it as a treasured piece. You can see where they had used glue and that to stick it to wherever they had it at the time. I'm not sure what this is either. Whoops, right here. Topaz crystal. I really should keep track of what my gems and stones really are, but if I like them, I just snatch them, and I really am not interested in their names. If I'm drawn to it, that's what I'll buy or If I find it, I'll keep it. If I don't like it, I'll pass it on or leave it. But this one was pretty. I liked it. And I'm not sure where I got it. There's plenty of gem places, or there used to be a gem place down in Bisbee, but I cannot remember the name of it, and he wasn't making enough money, I guess, down there, so he had to leave, had to go on to whatever else it was he was planning to do. And there's this piece. I do have a piece of coral somewhere that was my dad's, but I have no clue where that went to. It's around, hopefully somewhere, maybe packed up, I don't know. Because I was hoping to be moving soon, or at least this year, but I don't know if I'm going to be able to do that. Anywhom, this is just a clear stone, quartz, I believe, of some sort. I'm not really positive, but I like how clear it is. And some of these things I plan to maybe eventually make into jewelry. Oops, there's another couple of beautiful stones. I love the blue. The blue colors on these. Oops. Stuff is leaning, so it's all sliding off of there. But yeah, I love these. I don't mind my scraggly nails. They've been breaking and dry. I have to get them done. But yeah, some of these could be used for like worry stones because they have dips in them. I don't know if you could see the dip in that, but yeah. They have dips in them. But I love this blue color. It's very, very beautiful to me. Let me see what else I got here. Oh, Lordy. This I got out in the desert. Chiseled away. I used to live in a tent up in the Mule Mountains for a while. And there are caves up there where they do mining and that. And I found a lot of different things up there in the mountains, which upon I would climb up and down two or three times a day to town. We would go from the tent up in the mountains down into town, which was Bisbee's pretty small town. There's a lot of stores, a lot of artists there, but it's all compact, so it's small in shape. Now this stone I got out in the desert, and I liked the shape of it. What is that? Pac-Man. There we go. But I put my little cone incense right in this little crease here, right in there. And whatever else I would put up here and use it as like a traveling altar. It's small enough, flat enough to use. And that's just one of the other things I've got here. I found that in the desert too. Yes, people think that collecting bone is morbid. This is part of a vertebrae of an animal. And quite old. It's very dried out. But I collect these type of things too, because if it calls to me, if it's something that I feel I need for some reason or want, then I take it. Buy it or I take it. And that was found in the desert floor. On the ground. Now, let's see what else I got over here. These are teeny tiny. Little amethyst. And this crystal I found up in Coronado, I think, mountains or something like that. And it was laying on the ground, so I just picked it up. And here's another little piece. Not sure if it's amethyst. I'm not sure if these are amethyst or if they are sea glass or just melted glass. I'm not sure, but it looks amethyst to me. So here's another crystal I found. And here's another little stone, quartz I found. And a lot of this I would like to make into jewelry or incorporate into some type of thing. So that I'm using it and it's not just sitting out, not displayed. Now in here, see if I can get it to show. Is some raw turquoise. And it's just in a teeny tiny bottle. And those are ones that I would like to use also in or on something. Now, I have to put it down just for a second. I'll be right back. Now, these were found out by the Lavender Pit in Bisbee. It's got turquoise in it, raw turquoise, and I'm not really sure what to do with any of these yet. That one's pretty, I like that. They're just very, they go from big to small. And I'm always, when I was out there, I was always on the lookout for turquoise and gems and stuff. I'm not even sure what that is. Just a piece off of it, I guess. But some of them were being sanded down. They're really teeny tiny. And I'd sell them, but I'm not exactly sure exactly how much they're even worth, if anything. So that's the turquoise right there. Raw turquoise. I'll be back in a moment. And here's my little cauldron. I hold stuff in. And I have a combination of things in here. This piece of wood I gathered from Stockton Island, from the Apostle Islands, off the in Lake Superior there. Very beautiful place. Very beautiful. I was visited by a bear in the night there, so very nice. But I thought this was just really neat, so oh, excuse me, and in perfect condition, so I took it and kept it for memories and stuff, and I plan to use that in something too. Also found that on the ground, so some junior park ranger lost his little badge. And let's see, this piece of rock, kind of interesting. I just collected some of these at the Apostle Islands, at in the desert, because I like heat and I like water. So we've been into that. This one is quite sharp. Quite sharp. Very, probably use that to shave, guys. This is a piece of wood that I found at the Apostle Islands. And I liked it. The ridges and stuff. So I decided to keep that one, give it a home. Some of these I might put into terrariums when I make some, which I would like to do with some succulents and stuff someday. Because some of these rocks, they just have the patterns and stuff, and that just, I love them. There's some more turquoise. I love the sparkle on that. I don't know if you can see that, but I love that sparkle. I am a glitzy glitter girl, so I love sparkle. Oops. And unusual stones. I like them. I'm drawn to them. Not sure if there's even a name to any of these. Here's some more turquoise. I had a boyfriend at one point in time who collected these and tried to polish them up and that, but I think they look better when they're just raw like that. I loved this rock because it is shiny. I don't know what that's called, but I found it. And it's just so glittery. I wish I could show you better how glittery that is. Like gold flecks in it. I think this is a chunk of terracotta or something. I'm not exactly sure. I'm losing light over here because I get clouds out, so. Just things I would like to put in our terrarium when we use it. This actually was found in the desert. First, I didn't realize or didn't know what it was, but it's the part of a glasses, I believe. But it's all rusted out, and that was a piece of interesting stuff there. Here's some more turquoise. Geode. Showing you in there. Find my messy place here. There we go. Isn't that gorgeous? So that will definitely go into a terrarium or something. And this just flat. Piece of rock. Go that way. Here's another piece of turquoise. I love that. I'm I'm not sure what this is, but it's flat. And it's been, it looks like it's been chiseled or something, but. I don't know if, I can't remember if I found this in the mines or, but I love that gold. Another rock. It looks like it's been charred off. I think some of these are found out by the mines or the pit, the lavender pit. This one I find interesting. Interesting. Probably like it because it's got the dot. I don't know. Some of these I'm not even sure why I have them. This one is this is when they burn a certain stuff, I can't remember the name of it now, but this is when they burn, it's like a like after they burn wood and you get that charred, but this is like, I can't remember that. I hate it when I can't remember names of stuff, but I'm old, so yeah. But I liked it because it has a shiny, pretty look to it. That's that one. Here's some rose, I believe, quartz. Matches my towel here. By the way, that's my favorite beach towel I'm using. So there. Oh, when I lived up in the mountains in a tent, people, I'm not sure exactly who, I don't go to search and look, but they like to practice shooting up there. Also, one bad thing about Arizona is you get, well, you get people who kill people in certain areas. You got cartel, you've got border patrol, you've got illegals, druggers. Wow, I know how to speak. People dealing and buying drugs. And so, especially down by the border. So you do get, you know, you find dead people. So I just captured one of these because it was up there. I'm back. My camera ran out of time here, so anyhow, oh, the shell I found up in my favorite camping spot in the Mule Mountains, favorite, ultimate favorite camping spot, which toward the end before I left Arizona, somebody had overtaken and destroyed. So I was up there cleaning when I got stung by a scorpion on my hand. And no, I did not get sick. Well, I got sick, but I didn't get sick, so I had to go to the hospital. I just got a little sick. I'm not sure what this stone is either. I also turned the light on above us so that we have a little more light. Just a couple more pieces of turquoise. There. Another piece of turquoise. I'm trying to go quickly now because I'll run out of space on my thing. I got tons of little stones. Let's see, little stones, which will all go, like I said, into triniums or whatever. And just I love the different ways they look. Here's another piece of that, like, burnt, compressed, whatever. I still cannot remember the name of that, and that's very sharp on the end. What's that end there? Sharp! Trying to dig through plants here, too. More turquoise. It's too bad that you can't really see the color on that very well. But it's, take my word for it, it's beautiful. I love raw turquoise. This one was sanded down by my ex at the time. Focus. Come on, you can do it. I love that sparkle and glitter. On there. More turquoise. Love that. Another stone. I've got lots of little ones here. Let's, let me try to dig out some of these so you can see them all at once. Let's see them one by one here, maybe. This here is a piece of metal that was found up in the caves, up by the caves in the Meal Mountains, where they did the mining for the copper. Got little things in here too. I'm not sure. Oh, sage. Pieces of sage. Oops. Oops. Not even showing you. Little crystal. Baby crystal. Turquoise. More turquoise. This one's very nice white, shiny stone in the sun. More of that still. I can't remember it. Not even gonna try. Wanted to say stiletto, but I'm pretty sure that's not what that is called. But like I said, I can't be positive. Cannot be positive on that. Oops. I love this. It's just flat. And I believe that might be it in there. Not sure though, I'll keep hearing scrapey scrapey sounds. Alright, I think that's it for in here. Just got some really itty bitty tiny things. Alright, I will be back in just a second. This here, get it in my hand here. I made this, and it's like a little voodoo doll. This wire, this darker wire here, is all through here, twisted and turned. And it's wrapped in, thread, cross-stitch thread, and then I just attach a wire and some bells. And I had some beads here that I did. Let's see if I can get that turned for you. I made them to look like skulls. Little kids represented my children, girls and boys. And I just wrapped it and made it into like a dress. Feet, arms, head. Glued the stone on, which used to have a tear duct stone. And that is stuff that was found out in the desert. The wire, the stone, was bought at a store. The thread, of course, like probably at Walmart. Usually shop there. And the beads, I think, were found up in the desert, or up in the mountains, the Mille Mountains. And of course, I just attached. These were bought in Mexico. Those were Mexican. And that's what I made right there. I went and got my hair done at one point in time. And Dr. Feelgood's is the place's name. And I thought this was very interesting. So they were giving them away free. You pick one, you take one. And they painted on just a plain old rock. Plain old rock. Their logo, name, number, and that they're a hairdresser. I thought that was a really neat idea. So, when I saw that, I was like, well, anyone can do this. Talented, don't have to be. So that's a stone I keep as a memory of this place. Cause it, excuse me, I did really like the way they style hair, did nails and all that. And you'll find a lot of hairstylists down there, nail shops, tattoo parlors. So, I went out, and in the desert, I just found a stone, a rock, brought it home. It's quite heavy. And at the time, I was into skulls, and my favorite colors, pink. Pink and blues. Blues like the bracelet I'm wearing, if I could show it. I made that. I made one for my bestie, too. Hold on a second. Go. I love my BFF is what it's supposed to say, but it turns and twists. So anyway, I just made that stretchy bracelet, cheap, whatever. But I went out and I got this stone out in the desert by Twin Buttes and Twin Buttes Trailer Park between Bisbee and Douglas, Arizona, and I got that and I painted it the colors I like. Made a skull, put on some glitter, hodgepodge or whatever it, and now it's a bookend for my books. Over here, I can get it in there. Got my dresser. I mean, my headboard has some of my favorite books and some books I'm reading. The vegetarian one I got from Whimsy, Joyce Myers, and then some fashion ones. Two of my very favorite fashion ones. What else? Let's see. Then we got this rock I found out in the desert. Also, I can figure out how to show it to you. there we go. It's just so many different textures and colors in this. So I figured I could use this in a terrarium or as a bookend. So it sits up pretty stable, not too bad. And I loved how it just looks so out of this world, you know? peace in nature, when you feel it, when you touch these, it's like you're, well, you are connecting with nature. That's why I like to have them around. They're beautiful, they're old, they're ancient. Ancient. And you could tell that these are probably chopped or broken apart at some point in time. So that's that one. Oh, what else? Oh, yes. I used to live with a woman on a farm. On a rabbit farm. A bunny farm. And I would help her and her husband out. And one day I stumbled across her husband had shot a great horned owl, or whatever he calls. Very beautiful birds. Because it was snatching their cats and eating them. So he bowed it down with a bow and arrow, and I took one of the feathers as a remembrance of that, because I don't believe in killing animals for just plain old whatever, you know? I mean, if you're snatching your cats, don't have cats, you know? Keep an eye on your cats. Keep them indoors, whatever. I know you can't do it all the time, but, you know, that's kind of, it's sad, you know, that a bird like that had lost its life because of animals, you know? So that's that part, story to that. Let's see what else. Trying to do this fairly quickly. In Mexico, I got this little case, and I'm sure that you could get them anywhere. Probably not even in Mexico. And in them are what we call worry dolls. I'm sure people probably have seen this before. And it looks like one's missing. Where are you? There you are, two of them. Okay, there we go. It's stuck in the house. Okay, there we go. Now, there we go. Trying to get them all in the right direction here. Now, I'm a single mother. And we've had a rough life, very rough life. And I moved to that rabbit farm because of that rough life. In a way, it was an escape. In a way, it was to keep my sanity. So I just packed up and went to Arizona. I just left. Just left. And that was because I became single because of certain marital problems. Okay. I became single. And I put my worries in the box. Now, these five are representing my children. I have an older daughter from a separate person than my ex-husband. The other four are with my ex-husband. I have a son, and, excuse me, another son, a daughter, and a son. Well, right now, this daughter is all grown up, but before, in our very tough life, they were in and out of foster care a lot. They had a lot of problems with people, with just things. It's a hard but my oldest daughter is now married, and she lives in South Dakota with my grandbaby. And I would take these worry dolls out when they were younger and I was gone, and I would put them on my altar, and I would do all my worrying, wishing, hoping, praying, and sending off as much positive energy as I could to them, and hoping that everything was okay, because eventually these four were taken from me and set up for adoption. So my oldest daughter, she moved. These four, when they became 18, they never were adopted out because they have behavior problems, mental health issues. The oldest one here, he lives with me. And he's working and doing. Well, from someone I don't even know as I'm talking. So, needless to say, okay, the oldest one lives with me. Okay, there we go. So, then the other middle son, we had issues and he had to move out, and he got a guardian ad litem from someone other, well, the wife to the man. Okay, my husband's mother married this guy's husband, I mean, dad. Lord, it's a long story, but needless to say, this one is living with a guardian ad litem and refuses to have anything to do with me. They refuse. They have said a lot of bad things about me, so peace with them. This little girl here, when she came out of foster care and stuff, she moved in with me. We had our issues on and off. Now she is living with a boyfriend, I believe, in a couple of towns from us, about almost an hour's drive from us. This little one also lives in that town. When he came out, he never lived with me. He had his own apartment and that stuff, and right now, kind of having an issue with him wanting to move in with his father's mother. And just so you know, my ex-husband's family really did not have much to do with any of us at any point in time. And I don't think any of them with Josh at all. Maybe saw him once when he was a baby. Maybe. When they were being set up for adoption and stuff. Nothing. Nobody. They didn't come to say goodbye. Nothing. None of them wanted anything to do with any of them, is what I'm saying. So, I'm not trying to be mean or anything, but hey, truth is truth. Okay. This is a wand I made. It is made of willow. No, this was not taken from a tree. It was found on the ground in a park with my mother. And so I just made it into a wand. It's old, it's cracking, as you can see. It's very old. I've had it many years. I've carved and just went with the natural grain, the natural flow. As you can see, it's not all straight. Looks like a dinosaur. Oh, cluck, cluck, cluck. Okay, yeah. But that's something I made. Another thing I made. This one's gonna be hard to show. Here we go. Yeah, don't mind my mess in my room here. I have a major mess everywhere. Okay, now we went back to Arizona to drop my old sister off, who lives in Tucson. We stopped at the White Sands National Park in New Mexico, I believe, and I gathered some sand from there. I put that down at the bottom of an old candle jar, as you can see. Rocks in there that I have found, crystals, turquoise, just plain old rocks. And I liked them all, so I decided I would just stick them in this jar. Oh, and terracotta. Out at Twin Buttes when I lived there, we would go out in the desert, me and my sister. And there was broken glass everywhere. I mean, you could put together a whole car with car parts you find out there. Seats and just everything. I mean, just the desert has been like garbaged in different spots by people, unfortunately. But I find terracotta out there. And this is a large rattlesnake skin. Diamondback, probably. I'm not positive on that. But there was a place out in Arizona that I really liked that was called the Christensen Ranch. And I would have gave anything to have lived there. It was over 100 years old, out in the desert, next to the border of Mexico. I just loved it. It was old. It still had the old water towers. It had a small makeshift. It almost looked like a playhouse, but it was where the cowhands would stay while they were helping take care of the cows. And still had barns and just mud work barns where they were built with mud and stuff. It was wonderful. I would have loved to have lived out there, but yeah, my credit is screwed and my money and funds are very small. I live on a limited income because of health reasons. So those are just some of the stuff that I have collected from the desert. This one I call Witch's Stone. It has a hole that goes right there and comes out over here. So it goes straight through. And yeah, so this is my collection. I probably have more somewhere around, but Whimsy, she wanted to see it, and I have seen other people do videos on their collections and of gems and stuff, and so just so you know, there it all is, just all of this. So I hope you liked it. I know it was long and boring, but if any of you know the names of any of these stones or rocks, you can let me know, 'cause I know what the turquoise is, and that's in this bottle right here.